Hey everyone, I just wanted to say, first of all, thank you so much for 100 subscribers, that's amazing. I don't think, honestly, when we started this project, I don't think any of us really thought we would ever get that high. What do you guys think?
Yeah, no, that's
yeah.
A lot more than I ever expected.
That's like,
I'm so happy.
Just the amount of positivity and support we've gotten from everyone over the past, you know, 8 months, or even more than that, almost a year now, is just amazing. It's so cool that we get to do this, and that everyone seems to enjoy it. So let's dive right in. We're going to be watching a couple of our old videos and talking about them, and kind of some behind the scenes stuff that goes along with those, and then also answering some questions that you guys asked. So I think a great way to start this off would be to watch Wish You Were Here.
Our first
ever video.
Oh, look
who that is.
There's two of them.
It's two. Two of your boy. So young. So full of life.
Didn't know what the hell we were doing. Still kind of dumb, but...
Still kind of dumb, yeah. Oh, man. So, yeah, that video is pretty short.
I didn't know that.
That video is like 34 seconds long.
Oh.
This, when we made this video, we hadn't even conceived of earth tones yet.
At least not in its current form.
Yeah, because we were very excited by this. We figured out how to make it look like there's more than one of one single person there.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously that's me.
That took a while to figure out.
It took us like 2 days.
Yeah. Well, it took 2 days because I screwed up the camera, the first one.
Oh,
and I had you, like, the one where you're sitting on top, I had, like, the most of your head cut off the top part of the frame.
So, when we first did this, the idea was going to be for all the videos to just be me playing, and then Matthew filming. So that's the two people that were working on this video. So we got this one done, and, oh, the train. Do you want to talk about the train?
Oh, yeah, our set. So that's not a prop. That's the real deal. It's the
real
deal.
The real thing.
Basically, when I was like a year old, I think my dad was just like, I don't even remember how or why or like how this came about, but like basically he just saw a train, a caboose, for sale, and he was like, well, all right, I gotta buy that. So he did, and now we have that next to our house, and we're finally getting some use out of it, so that's good at least.
Yeah. So you probably recognize that from quite a few
It's been
videos.
In like four now, right?
There's a train in three or four videos, I think. Yeah.
Sorry,
that's gonna be our brand.
Then the song we did after this was Stairway to Heaven, which I consider the first real earth tones video. Because before that, we didn't really know what we were going to do with it. Because after we did Wish You Were Here, I was like, oh, I want to do Stairway to Heaven next. I just want to play the intro, you know, just play the guitar part. And I was thinking I could just learn the recorder part. I mean, you know, the flute part on the recorder. So I started working on that.
And as you can tell,
just not the,
that's why we got some
not
real
the greatest
players.
Idea. So that was when it took me about 10 minutes of working on that. And I was like, you know what? This is just going to not be good at all. So then these four lovely flute players who were in this video, I messaged them. I was like, hey, would you guys be interested in learning the flute parts at the beginning of Stairway to Heaven and doing a video with it? And then they were like, yeah, sure. So that's what I consider to be the beginning of the band, and probably that was in late September of last year, 2019.
This video was a bit of an ordeal in itself, because we spent like till 4 a.m. one night, just like going around looking for places to shoot, because we were like, okay, we're shooting tomorrow, everyone's ready, and we can't reschedule because that would be a dick thing to do. So we have to find a place, and it has to be good to film, except it's, like, pitch dark. Like, I don't even think the moon was out. And we were, like, looking around, and we're like, okay, we gotta find a place to film. And we ended up, like, driving way into the back roads of, like, behind the mountains where we live. And we're like, okay, here's a rock. We'll do it here.
We found several rocks, in fact, which is kind of how we got started there.
That's so cool.
And I kind of wanted to tie this in here to one of the questions. What inspired the forming of the band? So I think we kind of addressed that. I wanted to just do it by myself because I didn't really, you know, because I'm just a narcissist in the world, I guess. But then I tried playing recorder, and I'm like, this is just not going to be good. So then, you know, then just reaching out to other instrumentalists who are, you know, far better than I am, kind of opened the door and made me realize that this would be a way better project if we included you know, more people in it. And I would say about a week before we did the Stairway video, I came up with this idea. I was like, Earth Tones would be a cool name for a band because I'm like, my whole thing is I'm like a huge environmentalist, so I love, you know, the whole idea of like having Earth in the name of something. And Earth Tones, I thought, was a really cool, you know, name for a band because I not only love Earth Tones, mm-hmm. like the colors of Earth Tones, but like, you know, tones obviously a dumb meaning, it like also has to do with sound and music. So I thought Earth Tones would be a really cool name for a band. So we came up with that. And then, so I think we should watch a little taste of Stairway here. And would you believe it? This audio and the video are from two separate takes.
Oh, that's right.
But we use a metronome, so...
Oh, that's nice.
So it actually worked. You can probably drop in some of the original audio, Matthew, but... This part right here, it was just like wind noise, just completely. Like, you can see the branches moving and stuff.
Well, it was everyone's hair, too.
So it was, the audio left a lot to be desired, so then we recorded the audio separately in a closed room. Yeah, so there's no wind and stuff.
It's kind of cool. If you, like, watch all our videos in order, from earliest to, like, the most recent, like, you can kind of see our learning curve of, like, figuring out how to do this. Both, like, like, in the audio quality, the quality of the music everyone's playing, and then also, like, my edits. Like, there was a nice fade there, and there was a transition, and it's, like, just kind of like we were all learning how to do our parts.
This was way back in the day. We didn't even have a logo yet.
We didn't have a logo.
We didn't even have, like,
an end card.
Oh, wow.
Or, like, this was just our outro, a blank screen with text.
Yeah. And we weren't even using our favorite font.
Oh, that's right, our new favorite font.
Which is very important. Montserrat. Or Monster Rat, as we like to call it, is our favorite font.
I thought it's called Montserrat.
Yeah, probably something like that.
Fancy in French.
That's very French. Oh, oui, oui.
So yeah, that was one of the most fun. I mean, I think that was one of the best videos we've ever done, honestly. Let's see. Let's talk about what you guys think allows you to remain a band. Seeing as how most bands don't last.
That's a good question.
I mean, I think, like, what Kendrick has said before is, like, we're less of, like, a traditional band and more, like, a collective.
Yeah, I was going to say the same
thing. We kind of work together with a bunch of different people, and it's not, like, a core, it's not, like, a set thing, so it can change over time.
Let's see. Video you're most proud of. I think this would be cool to, for each of us to kind of...
Yeah, who wants to go first?
Take a stab at which one... Yeah.
Brag.
I think the first bloopers is the one that I'm the most proud of, just because it's like, it was the first one that I like started to do, and it allowed me to like learn how to do editing and stuff, and it let me flex that, and then also be funny, and just like kind
of. You want to watch a little taste of that one?
I think you know which bit we want to do.
She wears a smile
again.
That's satisfactory, I think.
Let's see.
Is it?
You said you wanted to. You were warming up your vocal cords. You wanted to sound better.
No. I'm saying.
And now we're recording.
If we do it tomorrow instead of today, then I'll actually have.
Oh, I thought you said that was what that was. Okay.
No.
Everything
that was good.
Yep.
That part right there, you want to talk about that? That took like
ten minutes. I was doing that with keyframes.
That like
just like each camera movement, I have to track it to his hand to keep it right in the center.
Yeah.
But oh my god, it's so good.
God.
Every bit in Angel is so good.
Yeah. This is that was
we still need to make an original song with the smoke bit.
Oh god.
Yeah.
Let's watch the My Eyes bit.
Boy.
It's always a spy pit smoke.
My eyes.
So this was, I'll tell you what's going on in my head here. We were testing the audio, but then smoke started blowing in my face right as we started recording. So I was just like trying to like keep going and like do something. And then I just played these chords and just kind of like started improvising something.
More motion tracking.
You're getting all this, right?
Yeah, that's not easy to do.
Especially I'm really glad you made sure you got that.
Any circular movement, there's like an x-axis and a y-axis, and you have to move both in like a specific thing in order to get it to move in a circle.
It's hard to get a fluid motion there. Especially back then, when we weren't as good as we are now at editing. Alright. What do you think, Andrew? What's your most proud video?
I think, for me, it's Better Together. Because still really proud of that arrangement.
Yeah. You want to talk a little about that? About the arrangement
process?
Was that
our biggest group?
Yeah, I mean, that one, it's like, you sent me, like, the chords, and then I just, like, kind of, you're just like, I want something jazzy. And I'm like, I don't really know how to do that, so I'm just going to mess around with this for a long time.
You like jazz.
And I just, like, kind of just messed around with the chords and instrumentation and stuff, and then we got this.
God. This part right here.
It took us a few takes to get it before we
could do it without laughing.
It's so good.
Yeah, because I can see your shoe right now.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Oh yeah,
it's so good. Let hit us with it.
Yeah,
let's
probably drop in like a couple clips of that.
That was really good.
It's just like the you see Gage's beating.
I see.
This video does not sound very good.
Oh, yeah, the audio quality.
Oh, look at you guys! You're just surprised.
Look how happy Gage is.
I think it's really funny, but like
man,
the two
Gage really like ties that whole thing together. Like just he's so good at drums.
The two smallest people have the biggest instruments, and that's really funny.
It's fun.
Like you're singing in this one, but you can't tell. Because when we were doing the editing, you're can you bring my voice down a little bit? And I was like, oh, okay, and I'd bring it down, and you're like, a little more, a little more, and it's just, like, inaudible.
I didn't sing while we were playing, because I couldn't sing and play the bass at the same time. I could probably do that now, but back then I wasn't very good at, you know, like, playing more than one thing at once. So I just kind of, like, lip-synced.
How did we record this, too? Because did we just do, like...
I think this was just camera audio, wasn't it?
This was just my phone.
Oh, yeah, we were using your phone. Yeah, and there's no way your voice would have picked up over four horns and a bass and drums.
Yeah, so I was... So I wasn't really singing, but then in post I recorded the audio of myself singing after all of the track. But then we were looking at it, and in my head anyways, I was like, for one, I didn't like the way I sounded. And two, I was like, this doesn't sound... Right, because I'm, like, singing way over there, and I'm not, like, with a mic or anything, so it, like, when you had the audio mixed in such a way that my voice was as loud as everything else, it just sounded and looked really unnatural, so that's why I wanted to bring it down some more, but it just ended
up.
It's also,
now,
like, way too fast, I noticed.
Yeah.
Like, it sounds like you're trying to get into, like, a triplet flow, and it's just, like, it's not what the song is, and it's just, like, ooh.
Yeah. That was not the case, but from an arranging perspective, it was amazing.
Maybe it's something we could revisit once everyone is like better at what we're doing.
Yeah. Alright, Christy, what do you think? Your most proud video?
My most proud video was I'll Get By.
Oh, that's a good one.
That one is really cool.
You like that one?
Not only. Yeah, because, like, we just met, like, what, people out of a country, mm-hmm. like out of internationally?
Yeah, there's people from like just... 9 countries, I think.
Yeah.
The
what was it? It was like Japan, Hungary, or not
Hungary,
Germany.
Hungary, was,
Ukraine?
Ukraine. Yeah, Germany, right. Spain, Brazil, I think. I can't remember.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember. There's so many people.
Yeah. Canada. There was lots and lots of people. That's also going to be my most proud video, mm-hmm. because that video, I mentioned in the Instagram story, but...
That was yours? That was your favorite?
Yeah, my most proud one, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to change to another one then. you can talk about it more. You can talk about that one more. Actually, my other favorite would be... Would You? That would be my first...
Yeah, your first appearance.
Video with you guys.
Back in January. You want to talk a little bit about, a little about the video?
Oh, yeah. It was really great. I felt, I think you texted, so it was, like, my first time getting to know the band, and then I was like, oh, hey, do you want to do vocals and ukulele? And I was like, okay, cool, sure. And I just realized I had... work.
Oh, yeah, we had to,
right after
like,
that
it was a really tight schedule
filming crunch time
we
on.
Got our last good take
yeah
and
it was
like,
hilarious
go.
But other than that, I gotta go but like it was a great it was my first time meeting Gage and you and yeah mm-hmm. and my first time meeting that set and I was like oh it was really cool we did what I didn't notice was like that one part when you guys started coming in
into
the chorus
the
I think
Let's find that part real quick.
Yeah, that was the proudest moment. I didn't even look until after, and I was like, what?
Yeah, that with the vignette. I forgot about that.
Oh, yeah, because I was
yeah,
standing.
You were in
I was standing right on that side. You could probably drop in the raw. I was standing right there, and I didn't realize it. But then we did like we did that, and it looked just so dumb. We just standing there, because I wasn't playing anything. I was just like standing there. So then we just put this huge vignette on it to just kind of cover that up. let's see how
it
find that spinning bit.
There it is. God, all the.
And then,
I'm sorry, I can't
I
look
remember.
At you. I'm just like my eyes are just fixed on Gage.
I know it's amazing. So,
yeah.
when we were planning on this video, I was like, "There's a pause here. I can spin my bass around, and that'll
mm-hmm.
look really cool, right?" So then I did that, mm-hmm. and then I remember after that we were editing this video. And I was like, we like watched this part over and over again. I was like, oh, look how cool it is when I spin my bass around. And then I didn't even notice what Gage
like...
did at the time. But rewatching the video,
yeah.
Gage is doing like this like freaking amazing trick with his stick. Like, watch this.
Oh,
what you see? Like, he spins it like around on
skills.
Top of his hand and then flips
it's
it. And
so
like,
I just love how it's all in time.
And we want to talk about
the
toss, of course.
Oh, that was good.
Oh, the toss!
The toss, TM.
Yeah.
There it
catch
is.
Yeah, you should trademark that.
God, look
yeah.
at that grip.
There it is.
That took
it was
so
like
15 long.
Tries.
That took us like, yeah. Because, and the problem was,
15 tries.
We kept on getting like these really solid
but
good
we kept
takes,
screwing up the...
But then like, I
dropped yeah, like
dropped
either
the
I would throw it wrong or he would like... just completely whiff the catch.
Yeah. And you can see how happy Christy is there.
Yeah,
but,
she's
like
we're done!
Like, we did it.
Yeah, we got it.
All right.
Good times.
Yeah.
Good times.
Oh, I want to say an honorable mention for favorite video: "Last Goodbye." That was really fun to make.
Oh God, that's maybe our worst video as far as
oh,
musical
yeah.
performance,
but like,
but probably our best from a visual
yeah.
standpoint.
I really like the way it looks, but like, oh, it's
so
not good.
If you wanna, if everyone wants to go watch that one with the audio off,
yeah,
that would be ideal. Because I suck at singing, apparently. I think it was we that was the song that kind of you kind of put a shift in our
it was
in our videos
wasn't it?
From then on because it was at that point that I realized that we were putting too much emphasis on like how we were caring too much about how
right.
the video looked and not enough about how it sounded because I was watching this video while we were editing it and it just I was just really not happy with the
mm-hmm.
way it sounded. I'm still not happy with it. It's just, it's not anywhere near as good as I could have done it if I just, you know, worked a little bit
but
harder
it looks
at it.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
But we, it looks amazing because we went up to Pimaca
mm-hmm.
and recorded this, like, all these beautiful shots. We spent so much time planning it out And then when we recorded it, we were just like did like one quick take of just me playing the song, and then just like went around and filmed
for
the rest of like
that
these,
one
these
like
shots.
Shot. We had it open and closed with you leaning on a tree and singing, and we didn't have a stand or anything, or even like the music. So you looked up the lyrics on your phone and handed it to me, and you're like, "Hold this out of shot." So I'm like standing there for 3 minutes while he's singing the song, holding with a phone, and I'm like, "Man, my arm's getting tired."
Yeah, that was not our best, but it looks great, and it was so much fun to record. Okay, here's one. What is a song that you'd love to do a cover of but haven't gotten the opportunity to do it yet?
I was thinking about this earlier today. What about a Kickstart My Heart cover?
That'd be cool.
I want to know what it would sound like with, like, a genre shift.
Oh, God, just a trombone just...
That would be really fun.
That'd be excellent. For me, a song that I've always wanted to do a cover of, but we haven't gotten the opportunity to yet, would be Yesterday. That was actually what's the sound? So I learned this guitar part, and I know how to sing it because it's I can sing it lower key, but like, you know, that song is so iconic, and I've listened to it like my entire life, so I know it pretty well. But get there one day.
Yeah. Hey Jude would also be fun, and then
that'd be really cool.
I'd want to do some Queen songs, but those are so iconic. Like, I don't even know if I want to touch them.
You can't really touch those because Freddie Mercury is so untouchable that you don't like anything that you try to do is gonna just fall short of that.
I've always wanted to do like any Jacob Collier. I mean, that's it'd be a tall order. You know, just like trying to do any of it.
There's a lot going on in those.
I really want to do Hedjanga, but just because like, I feel like it would really fit with just like all the instruments that we have. Like, I mean, just by sheer quantity of instruments.
Yeah. I hope we were able to answer your questions and give you a little bit more insight into the behind the scenes factor of some of our songs and kind of more about like who we are as people rather than just our music. I hope everyone has enjoyed that. And again, thank you so much for 100 subscribers. We can't even believe that we got that high already. And we're hoping
thank you guys.
Keep going.
Yeah.
So
the next 100 and further on.
Exactly. Yeah. Let us know if you guys like these kind of videos. Maybe we can keep doing this kind of thing.
Yeah.
For more milestones and stuff, but we'll see.
All right. Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye.
Thanks so much. All right. Bye, guys.